ألسنة الخلق أقلام الحق. The tongue of the creatures are the pen of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. We witness for each other. And Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم will come يوم القيامة to be witness for us inshallah. Not against us inshallah. Ya Allah. Make our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم witness for us يوم القيامة. So what we heard about sister, may Allah have mercy upon her and grant her Jannah, Ya Rabbi. She from people those who تتجافى جنوبهم عن المضاجع يدعون ربهم خوفا وطمعا ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. She prayed tahajjud. What I heard from her daughter, not in law daughter, her daughter Nazia and her daughter Shazia. What is sister Shazia? MashaAllah. Shazia and Nazia. Nazia said, she is my mother, not mother-in-law, she is my real mother. This is something unusual. Unusual for the daughter-in-law to look at her mother-in-law like her real mother and serving her, taking care of her. That person, that sister, did great for all people around her, especially for Sister Nazia and for others. That is a good sign. Prophet ﷺ, when they came to ask Hadrat Aisha radiallahu anha about Prophet ﷺ, about his manners, she replied, "Kana khuluquhu al-Qur'an." Khuluquhu al-Qur'an. His manners like Qur'an. And if you want to evaluate someone, ask the close people to him. Ask his wife. Ask his children, ask his friend, ask his close classmate, ask people they work with him every day, they meet with him every day. They will observe him and they will evaluate him well. So, sister, may Allah bless her and grant her Jannat al-Firdaus. All people, all her children, all her friends, they mentioned her in a very, very good way. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make these words witness for her, inshallah ta'ala. And may Allah Azza wa Jal accept our dua for her. We are here to raise our hands and to open our hearts and to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our dua for her. And we are here at this blessed house, blessed family, to tell our brothers and sisters Nazia, Shazia, Kashif, Nu'man, Salman, Brother Mahmoud, may Allah bless you, grant you long life, good health. To tell you, we love you all, and we are here for you. And we love your mother. We love this righteous lady who left behind her a great legacy, a good summah, good things. She is a role model for everyone. How to have حسن الختام. How to have good end in this life. Yesterday my khutbah was about husn al-khitam, was about sister. And how to have good husn al-khitam, this will be my next khutbah inshallah, if Allah grant me enough life inshallah for next week. We don't know. We don't have like guarantee if we will live till tomorrow. But we don't know. But we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our life. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us barakah in our life. To have good end, it is something great. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوعَدُونَ نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ نُزُلًا مِنْ غَفُورٍ رَحِيمٍ. For those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they do good deeds, they will have something special in dunya before akhirah. In dunya, Allah will send them the angels of mercy, of rahmah, to give them glad tidings. تتنزل. تتنزل in Arabic, Allah جل said تتنزل, not تنزل. And he might say just تنزل, only one تنزل. But he said تتنزل, meaning they kept coming, these angels, they kept coming to these believers day and night to give him that glad tidings. It is not once. Day and night. Day and night they will give him that glad tidings. That Allah is preparing something good for you. This is your seat in Jannah. This is your place in Jannah. This is your palace in Jannah. This is your house in Jannah. Every day, every night, these angels will come to him. We don't see that. But that person, his bed, at the last moment of his life, at the last few days of his life, he saw that. He saw that and he felt it. I remember that when Allah, may Allah have mercy upon my father and upon your mother, upon all your loved ones. The last 2 days, he was at like the death bed, and nobody inside his home, just my sister and her children. Her child, his name Ayham, he's 10th grade, he's not baby. And when he entered the room, slowly, nicely, quietly. Even though, when he entered quietly, my father opened his eyes and he thought, and he looked at him. He said, Ayham, don't make noise. I have guests and I have angels here. Do not make noise. There is no noise. But he hears something else. Allah will show that person at that moment something different. We don't feel it. Some people, they see Prophet ﷺ, like Hadrat Bilal, when he was at the last moment, his daughter came and she cried the last hour of his life. He opened his eyes and he told her, my daughter, do not cry. I'm going to meet my loved Prophet Muhammad, Abu Bakr, Umar, they are waiting for me. Look, he saw them at that moment. He said, غَدًا أَلْقَى الْأَحِبَّةِ مُحَمَّدًا وَصَحْرًا مُحَمَّدًا وَصَحْرًا. And with other righteous Imam earlier, Abu Al-Waqt al-Sajzi, his name Abu Al-Waqt al-Sajzi, he was a scholar, a muhaddith, mufassir, and he's at the last moment also, his student caught his head and put his head on his lap. And his student remind him to say kalima, la ilaha illallah, as we do with our loved ones when we have them. He said, oh my teacher, my sheikh, you taught us this hadith, man qala la ilaha illallah, dakhala al-jannah. Whoever said la ilaha illallah will enter al-jannah. And he replied, ya layta qawmi ya'lamun bima ghafara li rabbi wa ja'alani min al-mukramin. And then he completed this ayah from Surah Yasin until he finished all surah. Then he said, Allah, 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 Allah. And he closed his eyes and he died. Good end. May Allah grant us all good end. I mentioned this story, I'm sorry to mention it again, because some maybe sisters or brothers, they didn't attend yesterday khutbah. For the good end, one of a young man with an accident car, they took him through the hospital. And almost he will die, but his people around him, they started to tell him, okay, say la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah. And he said la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, and he started to recite Quran as well. And he said, I see my seat in Jannah here. What you are talking about? Already Allah just saw me. And he said, I smell the fragrance of Jannah, the smell of Jannah. I see it here. And he started to say, and he died. So they asked his father about that young man, youth. What did he do to say that, like a last word in his life? He said, wallahi, every night, every other night, he used to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pray tahajjud before Fajr. And he used to call us sometimes. He knocked the door of our bedrooms. Baba, Mama, if you want to pray, if you have before we pray Fajr together. It is this time, it is separate time, suhoor time. He used to call his brother, his sister, remind them to pray with tahajjud with him. So subhanAllah, these kind of people, they are a good example for us to learn from them. We still have chance now. We still have chance to get ready for that moment. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us good end, ya Rabbil Alameen. Sister Nasima, yes. Sister Nasima Ansari, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant her the highest level of Jannah, inshaAllah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ya Arhamar Rahimeen. Ya Akram al-Akrameen. Ighfir warham li'amatika Nasima Ansari. Ya Allah, ighfir laha warhamha. Ya Allah, ighfir laha warhamha. Ya Allah, ighfir laha warhamha. Ya Allah, afiha wa'afu anha. اللهم إنها نزلت بك وأنت خير منزول به. اللهم جافي الأرض عن جنبيها واجعل قبرها روضة من رياض الجنة. اللهم مد لها في قبرها مد بصرها. اللهم اجعل الملائكة زوارها يدخلون عليها من كل باب. سلام عليكم بما صبرتم فنعم عقبى الدار. يا رب أرها منزلها في الجنة. يا رب أرها مقعدها في الجنة. يا رب اجعل قبرها روضة من رياض الجنة. يا رب اجعل الملائكة زوارها يدخلون عليها من كل باب. سلام عليكم بما صبرتم فنعم عقبى الدار. اللهم اغفر لحينا وميتنا، صغيرنا وكبيرنا، ذكرنا وأنثانا، شاهدنا وغائبنا. من أحييته منا فأحيه على الإسلام، ومن توفيته منا فتوفه على كامل الإيمان. يا رب اغفر لشاهدنا وغائبنا. يا رب أتيناك هنا في هذا المنزل المبارك، نسألك الدعاء والمغفرة والرحمة لأختنا نسيمة أنصاري. يا رب تقبل دعاءنا، يا رب تقبل دعاءنا، يا رب تقبل دعاءنا، واجمعنا بها في جناتك جنات النعيم. يا رب اجمعنا مع أختنا وأمنا نسيمة أنصاري في جناتك جنات النعيم، وأدخلنا الجنة بغير حساب. اللهم ادخلنا الجنة بغير حساب. اللهم تقبل من أمتك نسيمة أنصاري أعمالها الصالحة. اللهم تقبل منها أعمالها الصالحة، واجعل ذلك نورا وثقيلا في ميزان حسناتها يا رب العالمين. يا الله forgive sister نسيمة أنصاري. يا الله have mercy upon her. يا الله grant her جنة الفردوس يا رب العالمين. يا الله grant her جنة الفردوس يا الله. يا الله grant her جنة الفردوس. يا الله have mercy upon her. يا الله have mercy upon her يا رب العالمين. يا الله let her enter الجنة without حساب. يا الله accept from her her good deeds يا رب العالمين. يا الله all people, all her friends, all her family members, all her friends saying good things about him. يا الله accept their saying يا رب العالمين. يا الله make that witness for her يا رب العالمين. يا الله make it heavy on his scale and his scale يا رب العالمين. يا الله make it نور light in her grave يا رب العالمين. يا الله make her grave piece of جنة يا رب العالمين. يا الله let her see her place in جنة يا رب العالمين. يا الله open for her a window from her grave to see her place in جنة يا رب العالمين. يا الله let all your angels, the angels of rahmah, of maghfirah, of mercy, come to visit her, Ya Rabb al-Alamin, day and night. Ya Rabb, let them give her glad tidings, Ya Rabb al-Alamin. Ya Rabb al-Alamin, accept our dua for him, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, accept our dua for him, Ya Rabb al-Alamin. Ya Allah, forgive us all, Ya Rabb al-Alamin. Ya Allah, forgive us all, Ya Rabb al-Alamin. Ya Allah, have mercy upon us all, Ya Rabb al-Alamin. Ya Allah, grant her family members al-sabr al-jamil. Ya Allah bless our brother, her husband, brother Mahmoud Ansari. Ya Allah bless her children, Kashif, Nu'man, Salman, and sister Nazia, sister Shazi. Ya Allah bless them, bless their children, all their loved ones. Ya Rabb bless them and grant them sabr al-jamil, Ya Rabb. Ya Allah grant them good health, long life. Ya Rabb grant them good life, Ya Rabb al-Alamin. Ya Allah let them and let us all follow the footsteps of our sister, Sister Nasima Ansari, and Ya Rabb, make us all righteous people, Ya Rabb al-Alamin. Ya Allah, grant us all good end and good life, Ya Rabb al-Alamin. Ya Arhamar Rahim, grant us the kalima before we leave this dunya, Ya Rabb al-Alamin. Ya Allah, let us remember, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. Ya Allah, make it witness for us. Ya Allah, make it heavy, Ya Rabb, in our skin, Ya Rabb al-Alamin. Ya Rabb, let us remember La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah as the last word in our life, Ya Rabb al-Alamin. Ya Allah, we ask you, Ya Allah, we ask you your forgiveness, your mercy, your rahmah, your peace, your maghfirah, Ya Rabb al-Alamin. Ya Allah, taqabbal minna Ramadan. Taqabbal minna Ramadan. تقبل منا رمضان يا رب العالمين. And grant us more رمضان يا رب العالمين. يا الله grant us more رمضان with good health, with good إيمان, with good life يا رب العالمين. For us and for all our beloved ones يا رب العالمين. يا أرحم الراحمين. تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم. تب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. يا الله bless this house يا رب العالمين. يا الله bless this house يا رب العالمين. يا الله bless this house. Ya Allah bless the people of this house, Ya Rabbi Al Alameen. Bless their food, their drink, their wealth, their rizq. Ya Rabbi, bless them all, Ya Rabbi. Grant them barakah, Ya Rabbi Al Alameen. Ya Allah bless all our brothers and sisters. They are here now. Ya Allah bless them, bless their families, Ya Rabbi Al Alameen. Ya Allah grant us all barakah, Ya Rabbi Al Alameen. Ya Allah strengthen our iman, Ya Rabbi. Ya Allah give us strong iman. Ya Allah, grant us enough faith, enough love to you and to your beloved one, loved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ya Allah, let us love our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam until we love him more than ourselves, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, let us follow his footsteps, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, make him shafi' for us in Akhirah, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, let him welcome us to let us enter Jannah without hisab, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin, with his shafa'ah, Ya Rabbi. Ya Allah, grant us his shafa'ah, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, let us visit his mosque in this dunya and pray at his masjid, Masjid al-Nabawi, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, grant us also to follow his sunnah, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, grant us his shafa'ah, Yawm al-Qiyamah. Let us drink water from his hand, from al-Kawthar, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Arham al-Rahimin, Ya Akram al-Akramin, Ya Ghiyath al-Mustaghifin, Ya Raja al-Sa'in, Ya Rabbi, istajib du'ana. Ya Allah, Ya Allah, respond to our dua, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Answer our dua, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, you know every one of us has a special dua, special request for him, for her, for our children, for our families, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, accept from us, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, fulfill our need, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. You know what we need, Ya Rabbi. Ya Allah, please, Ya Allah, give us good life, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Give us barakah, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, give us barakah, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, grant us happiness, tawfiq, success in this dunya and akhirah, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. Ya Allah, let us meet our sister, Naseema Ansari, and let us meet our beloved ones, our parents, in Jannat al-Firdaus, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. With the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مع النبيين والصديقين والشهدائي والصالحين. Ya Allah, let us all meet with each other in Jannat al-Firdaus. Ya Allah, as you gathered us here at this house, at this blessed house, Ya Allah, gathered us again in Jannat al-Firdaus, Ya Rabbi al-Alamin. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inna kunna min al-zalimin wa anta arhamur rahimin. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala nabina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Al-Fatiha. Now, I think Sister Naseema went to a better place, inshallah. I believe that, inshallah. We have hope. Now, what about us? What about us? This is a lesson for us all now to get ready. SubhanAllah, always, death, we don't need to talk in front of death, because death itself listen for everyone. No need to talk. Yesterday at the grave of Brother Imad, may Allah mercy upon him, well known, Isaiah Cemetery. I went, I said, what I will talk now? It is enough for us to understand that we are going to be here one day. We don't know when. Maybe tomorrow, maybe after 1 week, after 1 year, 2 years, we don't know. We are alive. We are waiting for the call from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to call us. The question is, are we ready or not? Do we prepare well for this moment or not? This question should we ask ourselves day and night. The rise between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala easy. Seek forgiveness and fix your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pray on time, give your zakah, perform hajj if you can, do zikr, recite Quran, this between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even if you have shortcoming between you and Allah, Allah azza wa jalla, our creator, Allah loves us. So with tawbah, with ma'am, Allah will take care. But things between us and others, here's the big issue. Here we need to
focus.
We have to fix it right now, without any delay. Without any delay. We don't know. Wallahi, what he said, brother, yesterday, brother Norman, he said, if anyone has anything with my mother, please forgive her. It is something not easy. Something not easy. He is very smart and wise and good child to ask people, if anyone has anything with my mother, any right, anything, please forgive her, or please come, let me know, and I will give you, and I will ask you to forgive me or forgive her or to give. Not easy. We might have no child to ask people, please let me know if you have anything. Maybe if someone has something with me, he will not come to my child or to my wife, to my family, or to tell them, hey, yes, I have something. Not only money, maybe something, I don't know. I will wait to see you in Yawm al-Qiyamah. I will take it. It will be difficult. It will be difficult. So let us fix things between us and our brothers, our sisters, our family members. Life is short. Life is short. Doesn't worth to fight. Doesn't worth to have that kind of argument. We will leave everything behind us. We will leave my cell phone, I will leave it. If I go to the grave, my wife will not put my cell phone with me. My wife will not send the car to me also to my grave. Will not send the house. Will not send my clothes, my thawb. Nice thawb, expensive thawb. I will leave everything. You will leave your gold. You will not take anything with you. Your account at bank, they will not bring that to nothing. We will leave everything. So what we are fighting for what? For what? So it is how it is good to think and reflect. I don't know if she said, I'm ready to meet Allah or somebody else, I don't know.
Always ready.
Always she says,
always ready.
Allah, it is something, again, it's not easy for someone to say, I'm ready to to go now.
Anytime she got
Allah,
sick, yeah.
Ya Allah, Ya Allah.
Yes.
Ya
Allah. I would like to add something, Sheikh. Before she finished her Quran, with Tafsir, Ibn Kathir, almost like a year ago, and it took her like almost a year to finish it. And so, mashallah, you know, after the, she was so happy. She always mentioned to me that, you know, I finished it. So, and she was happy inside that she read with the Tafsir, with the Ibn Kathir. She always wanted to do it, and she did it, mashallah. So that was it.
May Allah accept from her, inshallah, all her good deeds, Rabbil Alameen. So, my advice for myself, first, of course, first, and to all my respected brothers and sisters, to get ready for this moment, to get ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If someone asks you, are you ready to go? Let us have the answer, yes. We are driving every day. Driving meaning we are traveling. Even from your house to your work, you are traveling. You might see, a few days ago, brother Amran Sayyid, if you know him, he had accident, car accident, very bad accident. Alhamdulillah protected him. But his shoulder was broke, his leg, things. I visited him, and he came, alhamdulillah, pray Eid with us. Alhamdulillah, we're good, still alive, alhamdulillah. Allah has really got you and protected you. You and myself, every one of us might be that person. When you drive, we don't know what will happen. So we have to get ready. Whenever you go out from your house, Bismillah, tawakkaltu ala Allah. We don't know if we'll come back or not. So, sir, sister, a great, great sister, great teacher, and a great student. I'm so proud of you, sister Azra. May Allah bless you. She attend first Tajweed intensive class, second intensive Tajweed class, and our Tajweed halaqa, our ijazah, Quran, always she is number one, mashallah. And whenever she miss any class or thing, Sheikh, I missed my class, can I make it up next week? Can I make this? And Sheikh, if I didn't correct for her, Sheikh, you didn't correct anything. Anything, please, you are okay. Always she want to improve her Quran recitation. And mashallah, she is teacher.
Yeah, she's taught the entire Woodlands actually.
May Allah grant you long life, sister, to help us all and to have more good deeds, inshallah ta'ala. You are a good example for everyone. I know she is above of 35, 40 years, but mashallah. But she, mashallah, has always that niyyah, that attention to seek knowledge. What about our youth? About our young brothers and sisters. This is what we need to do to prepare and to improve our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through His Quran, through the Sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Connect with masjid, please. Please visit masjid, any masjid close to your house. Visit at least once a week, twice a week. Just visit the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just to be among us, those people, those who connect with the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to have the shade of Allah. The shade of Allah, وَرَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقْ بِالْمَسَاجِدِ. Let us have our children inside masjid. Let them know that this is our masjid, our house of Allah. This is the place we improve our iman, we connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we learn our deen, we listen to imam, we listen to scholars. We ask questions to know how to deal with things around us. May Allah Azza wa Jalla bless you all, brothers and sisters. May Allah Azza wa Jalla bless this gathering, inshallah ta'ala. May Allah give you barakah, may Allah give you barakah, may Allah give you barakah all, inshallah ta'ala. May Allah grant you all long, long life, good health, barakah in everything, inshallah ta'ala. Jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.